So in previous exercise, we have come across the use of the channel operator to integrate the animation into our TouchDesigner project. So for this one, we'll have a review of some of the other modeling process and how we can, in the end, after you finish your animation, to export the movie or digital movie into a standalone movie such that you can send it or distribute it to somewhere else. So we come with the standard configuration for this one. We have the geometry, camera, and the lighting. We have the rendering operator, and then finally we go to the output over here. And we also have the font 1 as a material to control the appearance of this one. So within the geometry, we try to play around it with a number of other processes. So we select another type of the primitive geometry, like for example a sphere, and then we pass it to a new command in the surface operation. So the command over here is the curve. And the step is you connect it over here. And then we can choose some of the parameter in order to play around with this curve command. So the curve is essentially a kind of cutting or extracting the original geometry. So we can, for example, do it in either the X or the Y direction. So the X direction is the U and the Y direction is the V. So we specify the start and end point of the Y direction, for example. So you can see the change in the number and the appearance of the graphics over here. So this is the second parameter. For example, I can use all over here and roughly a little bit more than half for the second control. And if you take a look at the results after you cut it into half, you can select the wheel and then do some rotation to actually see what is inside the half of the hemisphere. And the next step, we can also apply some sort of transformation in order to add a little bit more of sophistication in your animation, for example. So I make use of this particular noise over here. So I start the playback and then connect it over here. So this is the use of the noise. And you can have a look at the appearance. And you can also select other options for the use of the noise. So for this one, I use the position. And also I tune a little bit of the parameter. You can also take a look at the preview of what is inside and outside this particular surface. So once you are done with the modeling, you can turn on the display and the rendering thread and go back to your own project. So within the project, I try to put a material over here. So material font 1 is already here. So I try to put in a texture image. from the movie In. So I select one of the image I have prepared. And use this one at the color map to put it on top of this graphics. And then within the geometry, you can also manipulate about the like the rotation. And if you would like, you can also change some of the translation. And in this case, I can set my camera. So the normal one is 5. So in the last exercise, we move away from the objects. But for this one, I try to move a little bit in. And you can have a look at the graphic inside. So this is more or less what we are going to do for the final output. So in order to export the animation, you need to first of all have a look, for example, in the rendering window. You need to set up the resolution of this one. So I use a pretty small resolution for by 640 and 480 for the output. And the output window actually accommodate the resolution over here into its own. And for the export, you normally will try to do it in this way. You right click on your output window and then select the export movie. And it automatically tell you you are going to export the R1 over here. For this one, we do not add the audio part for this one. And then you type in the other parameter to select, for example, the frame per seconds. And also the codecs, the kind of compression. And also, for example, if you would like to export your location to somewhere else. And then once you are done, you can do the export. So normally it will have a duration of 600, that is the normal range of the timeline over here. You can see from the 1 to the 600. And it takes quite a while to compress the movie over here, depending on the codec you have selected. So once it's done, you can go back to have a look from your final location. So this will be the movie you have just exported from your TouchDesigner project. So this is pretty much the step we might need to follow when you would like to, for example, convert your artwork from the TouchDesigner project into something we can distribute to somewhere else. So of course you can add other functionality, like how you can, for example, we have just done by changing the translate rotate of this graphics by using the channel operator, or you can use your mouse to have more control of your graphics. So those are the steps you can follow to play around with your graphics in the TouchDesigner project.